Hello, dear colleagues. This is Dimitris Gouros from Athens, Greece, and I would like to make a short presentation of the dermatoscopic features of thin nodular melanoma. Nodular melanoma is a clinical entity that can be a diagnostic pitfall in everyday clinical practice, especially at its early phases of progression. Therefore, the International Dermoscopy Society conducted a multicentric international study trying to detect the special dermatoscopic features of thin and thick nodular melanomas. The final results of the study were recently published in the JADV. The threshold between thin and thick nodular melanomas was set to 2 mm of Breslow thickness. 69 cases of thin and 96 cases of thick nodular melanomas were collected, and the control group consisted of 89 cases of non-melanoma nodular tumors, either malignant or benign lesions. Demographics of the study showed that thin nodular melanomas were more commonly seen in younger ages among females and mostly arose on the extremities. In terms of structures and colorations, both thin and thick nodular melanomas turned out to be chaotic lesions, quite asymmetric lesions in terms of their dermatoscopic architecture. The most significant initial finding was that this light brown coloration was the most commonly observed color in the group of thin nodular melanomas. On the other hand, the group of non-pigmented thin nodular melanomas were less asymmetric lesions compared to pigmented thin nodular melanomas. An important finding explaining why in everyday clinical practice, early arising amelanotic nodular melanomas can be diagnostic pitfalls, such as this 1.6 thin nodular melanoma, looking like an irritated dermal nevus, or this 1.3 mm Breslow thickness early arising nodular melanoma mimicking a basal cell carcinoma with this typical linear irregular vessels. Concerning the special dermatoscopic features of nodular melanomas, the most commonly observed dermatoscopic feature in the group of thin nodular melanomas were these irregular brown dots and globules which can be seen at the periphery of the lesion on the left side of the slide, followed by irregular blue structureless pigmentation along with white shiny lines. Eccentric black blots was also a common finding in the group of thin nodular melanoma combined with all the aforementioned dermatoscopic criteria. On the other hand, in the group of thin but non-pigmented nodular melanomas, dotted vessels, as you can see here, diffusely arranged on this tiny 0.5 mm Breslow thickness nodular melanoma, followed by serpentine vessels, linear irregular serpentine vessels, were the two most common vascular findings in this group of non-pigmented thin nodular melanomas. On the contrary, for thicker nodular melanomas, linear irregular vessels along with blue-black pigmentation and prominent ulcerations were typical of thicker nodular melanomas. Predictors, dermatoscopic predictors of thin nodular melanomas. Dermatoscopic predictors of thin nodular melanomas compared with any other type of non-melanoma nodular tumors were the irregular blue structureless pigmentation, the white shiny lines, and dotted vessels. Irregular blue structureless pigmentation in the group of thin nodular melanomas was a pigmentation diffusely arranged in the lesion on the tumor, compared with let's say more circumscribed blue-gray globular bluish pigmentation of basal cell carcinomas. Dotted vessels along with short shiny white lines were also very strong clues for thin nodular melanomas compared with any other type of benign or barely more malignant nodular but non-melanoma tumors. Comparing thin versus thick nodular melanomas, light brown coloration, as you can see here on the left side of the slide, was the most, the strongest criterion predictor for thin nodular melanomas, while on the other hand, serpentine vessels was a strong predictor for thicker nodular melanomas. All these criteria, irregular blue structureless pigmentation, serpentine vessels and dotted vessels, were also strong predictors, dermatoscopic predictors for nodular melanomas of any type, irrelevant of their Breslow thickness. So, to recap, dotted vessels in a nodule should always raise the flag of suspicion for a thin nodular melanoma. Always put a thin nodular melanoma in your differential diagnosis whenever confronting an early arising nodule with relative asymmetry and this diffuse light brownish pigmentation. Beware, early thin nodular melanomas are great imitators in everyday clinical practice. While on the other hand, thicker nodular melanomas exhibit more striking melanoma criteria such as irregular blue-black structureless pigmentation, vascular polymorphism, or prominent ulceration. In conclusion, dotted vessels in an early arising nodule, along with irregular blue structureless pigmentation and short, white, shiny lines, are strong predictors of early arising nodular melanomas compared with any other type of benign or malignant nodular non-melanoma tumors.